This number of angles focuses on the extraordinary production of verse written on and during the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, with a special focus on the period of lockdown in 2020. As with previous historical crises, the pandemic strikingly revitalized the role of the professional and amateur poet in the city. The 2020 surge of occasional poetry, self-conscious and historically aware, is emblematic of our age of witnessing, enamored of the archive and the record, exploring new realms of memory through the digital medium. The huge number of poetry projects spearheaded by local and global communities, by universities and cultural councils in 2020, revealed how poetry is still considered the most spontaneous literary response to crisis in its immediacy, at least in the Anglophone world. The words of former British poet laureate Cara Ann Duffy, "We need the voice of poetry in times of change and world grief," seem to encapsulate a widely shared view on the therapeutic and connective role of poetry in times of global upheaval. Concurrently to the environmental crisis, which has in some ways reaffirmed the role of poetry as a potential agent of change, vector of the collective and voice of responsibility, public institutions and private citizens charged poetry of archiving and memorialising individual experiences of the pandemic, effectively turning poetry databases into sites of memory in an attempt to foster national and transnational communities across the globe. Unlike other health catastrophes, namely the 1918 influenza pandemic or the AIDS epidemic, COVID-19 was indeed memorialised and conceptualized immediately as a shared, collective, not to say global, trauma. This thematic issue approaches poetry of the COVID-19 crisis as a historical, social, cultural, and literary phenomenon through academic papers, as well as creative essays, poems, and commented translations into French. Almost 5 years after the onset of the pandemic, all the contributions attest to the symbolic staying power of an event which has not finished being discussed in literature. The issue addresses current aesthetic, critical and political questions linked to eco-poetics, post-colonial studies, medical humanities, trauma studies and ethics of care, as well as giving a compelling platform to occasional verse, often overlooked by canonical criticism. Evolving literary practices, specifically the blurred lines between public and private poetry and individual and collaborative work on digital interfaces, as well as the uniqueness of the pandemic experience spanning across several scales, are at the heart of this number, which also offers a stimulating reflection on the circulation and reception of poetry in the digital age, the influence of online communities and public policies in poeticizing historical circumstance, but also the resistance of more traditional lyric modes in times of crisis. Thank you.